Hey guys, I'm here with a Transformers Universe review of Universe Classics 2.0, whichever name you prefer, Cyclonus. Cyclonus is an amazing figure. Look at this guy. Look at him, does he look nice? Now this is pretty much a completely updated version of the Target Master Cyclonus, which was basically the original G1 Cyclonus, just with an added peg hole, so you could give him this fancy-dancy little gun. The gun does come off, just set to the side. And here is Cyclonus. Now, I do not personally own the original G1 Cyclonus, so I cannot do a direct comparison, but what I can do, since I like to own stuff, I like to own books, I have a picture. Let's put that aside. I have the original G1 Cyclonus, so there he is there, and there he is, so I'm not sure how I could really work that out where you could see both, but it is a nice update, minus a few stickers that they had back in the 80s. There's the original Cyclonus. Vehicle mode looks great. Robot mode, well, it's G1, so, you know, that sounds really mean, doesn't it? And the original Target Master also came with a little gun that was named Nightstick, much like the Universe version does. So, enough of that. Very nice vehicle mode. Very, very G1-esque. This is, in my opinion, one of those figures where it is a true update to a G1 classic. Others like that would be Inferno. Inferno, I think, is a fantastic update, and I plan to do him very shortly. So, he comes with these landing gears that you can fold away, so he can fly away and save the day for the Decepticons at the bay. Okay, I'm goofy, what can I say? So, very nice, very good, very nice vehicle mode. He has this pretty cool little translucent red right here. I don't know if you can really see that, but maybe if I get it right you can look at it, but I don't know. It's translucent in there, just trust me, it's translucent. And gonna transform me. He's got a pretty cool little transformation, I think it's rather different. First, slide in the nose cone, there's a little tab up here. Just slide that back, or just hit the tip and it'll slide right in. So, there you go. Magic. Unpeg his wings, slide them forward and rotate. Do that fancy dancy stuff. Grab its legs, and this is kind of cool, I think. You're going to fold out each leg, so you'll do this holo maneuver. And then once they are separated, slide them down, and they click together, forming a pretty solid-looking leg. He's got fantastic legs. He could be a model. And there is a difference to how the legs will look from each other. So, undo, spin it down, lock it in place, open, feedums. And he's getting there. You can pretty much tell what's going on now. Before you lock these guys in, you're going to fold the nose cone and the cockpit back, slide in the nose cone, turn his head around, fold that into his back, slide the arms in, click them in place, rotate them around, and you can pretty much see where you're going to go from here. Grab the arms, unpeg them from his wings, there's a little tab in there, and extend the arms down. Unpeg, extend, click the arms back in place if they come dislodged. Now you're going to reach inside this little tab here, push that in place, and that will slide his fist out, and then you can just grab the whole thing, and then spin the arms so the wing is on the outside. Same with this one. There's that. Last but not least, take his wings, and you're going to swing them back like this, kind of clicking in place. They don't really click in anywhere, but they should look like this. You can still see the wings, and they are back far enough that so you can have full clearance with the arms. There's no problems at all there. And there you have Cyclonus. Kind of get his fist aligned so that they are kind of flush with the exhaust, I'm guessing, the thruster of the jet mode. But there you have him. Nice looking figure. I really like this guy. Articulation wise, the arms have full movement. You may have, you know, kind of force a little bit because the wings kind of want to stop, but full movements. They do have a little bit of pivoting action there. It does have elbows. They do bend. They don't bend backwards. I'm sorry. And, you know, you can just turn his wrists, kind of. Leg-wise, this, he has knees. He's got knees. Everybody loves knees. You can get a pretty nice little variety of movements. They do pivot outwards, so you can get a split going if you desperately want to. If you're a cheerleader, maybe you like doing splits with your figures, but I don't know. And his feet, you could say these could count as some form of movement. I'm not, because it doesn't really help anything. And his head with the bunny ears goes the full 360. Light piping for this guy is pretty nice. So I'd actually do this right the first try. Hey, I did it. Look at that. Isn't that fantastic? Nice logo in the front for the Decepticon home team. This guy is very nice. I definitely do love this figure. He's up there, I think, with on par with what Universe should be. Not just, you know, let's take Cybertron and paint him in G1 colors. No, let's make new figures based on G1. Love it. Now, Nightstick is his gun, Target Master. You can have him hold the gun like this. It fits in his hand perfectly. It's a big, big freaking cannon. But if you want to transform it, fold this all back, fold everything around, fold the arms down, fold the feet down, and you've got Nightstick. You could call him a Minicon if you are from the Armada age, but Target Master was around before Armada. He's not a Minicon, he's a Target Master. And the arms, full movements, he has elbow joints, the head will not rotate. The legs have, you know, pretty solid stiff movement, not a whole lot going on there. This guy is actually fairly well detailed. He could use some more paint application, but for something that's his small, I'm really not surprised they didn't, you know, really do much paint on him, aside from the base color. But he definitely does look pretty cool. And Cyclonus, just, when these guys get talking about things, they work issues out. They're always talking, they're always hanging out. It's rather annoying because Cyclonus is a bit of a jabberjaw. He doesn't shut up. So it's nice that he has a buddy to keep him company. Otherwise, you know, maybe you have to put him down. But there he is with Nightstick. There you go. Highly recommended. Pick him up. He definitely is bigger than the Galvatron figure that was released for Universe, but I'm never going to dig mine out because I really dislike the figure quite a bit. And I think I hear my dinner has come home. This guy is suddenly not standing. That's kind of odd. There you go. But that's it. Hope you guys enjoyed the review. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.